Those abundant ship in a relationship. Things can get tough in relationships, and it's not always going to be a walk in the park. Despite how much you both love and adore each other, a gentleman will always support and be there for his partner, even during the most challenging of times. A gentleman never lies to a woman. To be honest, this shouldn't be gender specific either. Liars are bag eggs, full stop. The only time they are acceptable are when they involve Father Christmas or a woman has had a questionable visit to a hair salon. She knows it's bad, you know it's bad, she knows you know it's bad. So, see it looks wonderful and move on. Be respectful. A gentleman is respectful to everyone around them, not just women that they're on a date with. Be polite to everyone you meet, even if they're just a plain rude asshole. You come out of it looking like the better person, that's for sure. Treat women with respect. The worst thing you can do to a woman is look her up and down like she's a piece of meat. Women are human beings with their own thoughts, hopes and goals, and you should never ogle them and treat them like they're only there to serve as a feast for your eyes. When you meet a new woman, ask her name and get to know her for real, instead of just staring at her like you're undressing her in your mind. Gentlemen understand that women are to be treated with respect. They don't talk to them with cheesy pickup lines and prefer some tasteful, light-hearted flirting instead. Maintain proper hygiene. A gentleman looks and smells pleasant when out in public. It's one thing to sweat while working out, but not while out and about. Take regular care of your body and that you look polished and clean before you step out. Make sure to bathe regularly. Use of hair product is fine, but be careful of hair gel. This product can be sticky and get rock hard after a while, making your hair look stiff. If you don't smell clean and fresh, then it doesn't really matter how charming you are or how your clothes look. It's important to get the hygiene down so people don't get distracted by an unpleasant odor or appearance. Wash your hand after you use the bathroom. A gentleman cares for himself and others by preventing spread of disease. Also, other men in the washroom will notice if you bypass the sinks. A gentleman is the same person in public and private. This is the most critical point in this list. Above all else, a gentleman conducts himself the same way in private as he does in public. There is no duplicity, double dealing, or deception. A true gentleman has the courage to have one set of values, no matter the audience. This doesn't not mean that they never make mistakes. Everyone fails to live up to their own standards from time to time. However, gentlemen own up to this failure and learn from them. A gentleman is civil in uncivil times. Whenever money, pride, or ego are at stake, tension is sure to flare. People will react with vitriol, personal attacks, and other forms of aggressions. Gentlemen do not respond in kind. Instead, they fall back on a higher set of principles, even when attacked. This civility is not a sign of weakness. Instead, it's a sign of strength. We must all do our part to raise the bar concerning our conduct. Connect with people. Say hello as you're walking past a stranger. Let someone go in front of you in a grocery line. Make eye contact. Be approachable. It's one of the best ways to open yourself up to new people, experiences, and professional connection. To be a gentleman while you're out, always remember it's all about them. Be a good listener. Ask questions. Take note of what's important to them, and they will take notes of you. Do not discriminate. A gentleman is a fair man. He does not discriminate. He gives people what due to them and not make biased judgment based on their race, social status, religions, or educational attainment. His eyes looks beyond the superficial features and focus on the things that really makes up a person, the character. Be clear about what you want. Not making a decision is a decision in itself, and it's not a good one. If you want the respect of others, know what you want and what you don't, and be clear about it. Knowing how to say no is one of the most well-respected things you can do for yourself. You don't want to be a wishy-washy person who constantly flakes on those you care about because you overcommit, and you certainly don't want to be the guy with no opinion or backbone.